This whole adventure, capital I insane. I married Sonia? I have a kid who actually likes me? Inquiring minds want to know how the hell that happens. So I get the hourglass to show me how kicking Shinnok's ass, which I did beautifully, turned me from Hollywood megastar into global icon. So far, so good. Until I let that thing screw me up. Didn't hit rock bottom until I saw just how badly I'd let down my own girl. I finally got what old man Mead was saying about needing humility and maturity. But I also knew I couldn't get there without living the same life he did. So, there's still the timeline, just as it was. With one tiny little difference. Sonya's story won't end underneath the rubble of some busted up Neverland castle. Because Johnny Cage flicks always have happy endings.
I cut a lot of deals, but none spiffier than this. I spared Kroniger. She gave up the hourglass. The power to shape time and history to my liking? Fuck yeah. I set it up so that everything came out aces. Every desire, every wish, every whim I ever had, done and done. But I realized pretty quick I'd suck the fun out of things. Without a fight, winning was worthless. Nah, the fun wasn't in the having. It was in the getting. So, I changed things up one more time. Now, what I want is always just out of reach. I gotta earn it. I score lots of wins, but not always. When I do win, it's something to say.
What does it mean to wield the sands of time? To be the chosen one. It means making choices that break your heart. For the protection of all, I shared Kronika's power with the people I trust and love most. Together, we replaced the Elder Gods that Cetrion had betrayed and became eternal guardians of the realms. See, my heart longs for a simpler life. The kind one cannot have being chosen, let alone an Elder God. What Kitana and I would not give for those simple pleasures. In another timeline, it could be ours.
Kronika had manipulated me. In timeline after timeline, she stoked my anger and fed my arrogance, turning me against Liu Kang. My nose rubbed in my own fallibility. I was humbled. How could I be worthy to accept the mantle as Keeper of Time? I thought that to control time and destiny fairly, I must purge myself of all human emotion. Summoning the strongest magic, I burned away my fear and anger. All that remained was pure logic. But I learned quickly that the logical choice is often not the just choice. Unless tempered by compassion and heart, logic leads to decisions no better than those based on anger or fear. Now I am once more at time's beginning, but on this journey through history, I will infuse logic with love. In this timeline, I will finally achieve peace for the citizens of all realms. I made my future self a promise that I would not stay mired in the past. But once I controlled the hourglass, I could not keep that promise. I had to restore my faith.
family. Over and over, I crafted the sands of time. Yet in every new timeline, my family's tragedy repeated. I was powerless to change it. After eons, I learned the truth. Kronika was not alone. She was one of many titans, each more powerful, and ancient of the Elder Gods. It is they who conspire against us. Myself, my family, we are pawns in the game. Why? I do not know. But I will find out the name, and then I will have vengeance. Kronika's power overwhelmed me, such that I would have been driven mad had I not spent centuries mastering the dark powers beyond the grasp of ordinary mortals. Now, I am the master of time and fate. But Kronika's fall proves that even titans can be defeated. Lets me run infinite timelines and feast upon the souls of billions. I am one. To survive, I must return to the shadows, avoid confrontation, and work my will through the hands of others. More specifically, through the hands of my fellow titans. These monstrous beings are plied easily by appealing to their greed, vanity, and fear. Every soul in eternity bends to my influence. In my new era, morality will be exposed as the illusion it is. The clone will prosper, while the good suffer. This is the word of Shang Tsung. Have a nice day.
None of us saw Kronika coming, not even Raiden. But with the hourglass, I can see every terror in the realms. Any sane person would run screaming at the sight of them. It's my duty to take out these ancient, all-powerful beings. But to do that, I need an elite squad of immortal gods. Turns out, to make a new god, you've got to destroy an old one. So I hunt the oldest I can find, an omni deity from a forgotten, unpronounceably named realm. It's the fight of my life, but I've got something this god doesn't. Family. In my past, these were the people who mattered most. Now, they're my god squad. My daughter, my brother-in-arms, my goddaughter. Yep, even Johnny. But only because Cassie insisted. And maybe I missed him a little. Just don't let him know.
Once I gained the hourglass, my first thought was to rewrite history and redeem the Lin Kuei's honor. Then I thought of Bi-Han, his life consumed by evil. Before I could redeem my clan, I had to redeem my brother. With the hourglass, I wound back time to our childhood. I studied every second of Bi-Han's life to understand why. Why he embraced Sektor's corruption. Why he reveled in the vile power given to him by Quan Chi. Armed with that knowledge,